See, permutation, first of all, before we go ahead for binomial distribution, I'll do a small recap for your permutations and combinations. Permutations and combinations. The difference is very simple. Permutation involves this. If you change the order, it is counted as a new event. Okay? So order is important. What is permutation? Here, order is important. For example, I have 1 and 2. I write 12. If it is a number, then 12 is something else and 21 is something else. I have changed the order. It is counted as a new event. It is counted as something, they are distinguishable. If you change the order, it is distinguishable. Combination is, order is not important. Order is not important. See, the same two people, if that is the jersey number of two people, 1 and 2, and you are selecting them for a team, 1, 2 forms the same team as 2, 1. Get the point? So this is a combination. This is the simplest difference between permutation and combination, and this is the only difference. Okay. You just check whether if you change the order, things change. So forming a team, example, forming a team is a combination. While if it is a number, okay, or say as you said, people are seated in an order and they are distinguishable. Mm-hmm. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So if they change their places, you close your eyes, open your eyes, you'll be able to tell that yes, they have changed. Permutation. If they're treating them as a team, and you're not bothered where they sit on these four chairs, ultimately, that is the team that will go into the field. So it does not matter where they are sitting. The team remains the same. Okay? That's a combination. Now, there are two simple rules that we should know when dealing with permutation and combination. One is called the product rule. And it is what? If a full task, this is the full task, it can be divided into certain subtasks, each independent of the other. Each independent of the other, and if this subtask can be done in M and this in N and this in P ways, then the full task will be done in M into N into P ways. So, a task divided into subtasks, each of which can be independently done in M, N, P ways, then the task is done in M into N into P ways. This is called the product rule. Okay? So it is a series kind of thing. Okay? A child getting dressed. Okay? He has 3 trousers, 4 shirts,
2 jackets,
6 socks. he can get ready in how many ways? 3 into 4 into 2. 24 ways. And they'll be distinguishable. Okay, that is permutation. Okay. Now we come to the sum rule. Sum rule. What is the sum rule? If there are alternate ways of doing the same task. Okay. So for example, I say one has to reach from A to B. There is a possibility you take the airways and you take the railways. There's another possibility that you take a ship and then you take a roadways, and there is another way that you take the ship followed by a rail and followed by an airplane. Okay. Here you can take the airplane in two ways and rail in three ways. Here you can take this in three ways and this in four ways. Here 3, 2, 5. Then what happens? Through the first route he can go in 6 ways. Through the second row he can go in 12 ways. And through this way he can go in 30 ways. So the total number of ways becomes 48. It is the sum of the parallel paths. These are two options. Even amongst airways, there may be two flights or whatever. Okay. That is called the sum rule. So you have to very well understand whether what is, and this is what is or. So he can take route 1 or route 2 or route 3. While for getting here, for getting dressed, he has to do this, this and this. Then the whole dressing gets completed. Correct. So here for one path, he has to take the airways and the railways. Here too, the ship and the roadways. Here too, the ship and the rail and the airways. So that's why they are getting multiplied, while these are alternate routes. So they are getting added. It's commonsensical. You should understand that. Now, you can directly apply the formula. For example, I have got 5 digits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I have to take 3 out of them and I am supposed to find a number. Okay, I am supposed to find a number. So that can be done in, see, I have to form a 3-digit number with it. They can be done in how many ways? I can take any of the 5 here, if repetition is not allowed. Any 5 here, 4 here and 3. So that is 60. And that is denoted by 5P3. 5P3 is what? Out of 5, permutation of 3 things. And how do we define that? We define NPR as N factorial upon N minus R factorial. So it is 5 factorial upon 2 factorial, which is 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 factorial divided by 2 factorial cancels 60. What do you got here? You get there. Okay. Okay. Now, out of these 5 people, if I had to select a team, how? Okay. Then it would have become a combination, and NCR is N factorial upon. That's good. Hold on. Just try to think. I have selected 3 of them in how many ways? 5P3 ways. Okay. Now just try to understand. I have selected 3. After that, I have shuffled them in how many ways? 3 factorial ways. 3 things, once you have selected, they can be shuffled in how many ways? 3 factorial ways. Any of the 3 you can put here, and any of the 2 here, and any of the 1. So it involves 2 stages. First of all, you pick any 3. After you have picked up, you arrange those 3. Correct. Now just try to think, if these were the jersey numbers of the people, of the players, and I was picking 3 players out of them. Okay, so suppose I was doing the same thing. After I have selected 3, the 3 factorial ways in which I have arranged them will count as only 1 if we are treating it as a team selection. यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट, जब तीन को सिलेक्ट कर लिया, ऑल दोज थ्री हैव बीन सिलेक्टेड एंड देन आई एम ट्राइंग टू शफल देम, देन दैट शफलिंग ऑफ थ्री पीपल इन थ्री फैक्टोरियल वेज इज डिफंक्ट, दैट इज ओनली वन टीम. So if I divide 5p3 by 3 factorial, that means every 3 factorial movement is counted as 1. So I'll have to divide it. So if I divide 5p3 divided by 3 factorial, that should give me 5c3. That is how it is defined. So NCR is defined like what? It is NPR. You have selected R. And the shuffling that you did amongst those R in R factorial ways, that is defunct for a combination. Why? Because the order is not important. You take 1, 2, 3 or 1, 3, 2 or 2, 3, 1 or 2, 1, 3 or 3, 1, 2 or 3, 2, 1, that is all the same. If you are selecting a team, that means if it is a combination. So that's why the formula for this becomes NPR is N factorial upon N minus R factorial, that it gets divided by this. So that's why the formula for NCR becomes that. That's why. You understand the funda? Fine. If you understand, it will be enough to solve whatever binomial trials we'll get. Okay, and now it will help you understand things better. So you've written it? Fine.